I was a runner and a dancer, so being thin to me was sort of the ideal.
On TV screens, billboards, and magazines, the message is repeated over and over, thin is in. For thousands of Pennsylvania teens, the unattainable ideal of thinness being the key to happiness turns from a healthy lifestyle and spirals into a dangerous and sometimes deadly eating disorder.
The problems and challenges that eating disorders pose.
State lawmakers are stepping forward to try and reverse this growing trend, in part by holding a public meeting to discuss a plan to raise awareness among the teachers and parents of teenagers targeted by eating disorders. A mother who lost her daughter to an eating disorder and a young woman who is recovering from her own six-year battle stepped forward sharing their painful stories in support for change.
So if the state can mandate messages to parents, and this bill also has an option for schools to develop a screening program, both aspects of that are positive.
Parents have to sort of recognize that their child is suffering, so I don't think having parents know about the symptoms and the signs, they can help their child and sort of how to approach them if they do see it. So I think that's really important.
Under the bill, school districts would be required to share information and resources about eating disorders with parents of children who are in 5th through 12th grade.